Hi there! Since the release of Scrap Mechanic in January 2016, we had no way to say how fast something is going in-game. But today we are measuring this in FHS. In this episode we are going to check, what's the science behind this? What's the technology that we use in order to create our top 72 list of fastest creations in Scrap Mechanic? Let's start the countdown now! Thank you for joining. And before starting with our list, let's talk about our rules. Each competition has ones, but today they're pretty simple. The creation should not use mods, meaning to be made only of vanilla parts. It has to fit our time measurement gates in size. Each creation does as much passes as needed for good and accurate time. And I tell you, some were a nightmare to test long-lasting hours, while others were so fun and cool that we wanted to spare even more time with them. Let's start with a great example for such creation. Two huge eyes, six legs, alien-looking bug, and top speed of 1.81 FHS. On the bottom of our list is the Walker by Firestone. It looks dangerous, and it has a cannon on the top that can be activated. And you would use it, as you'll be blown away by the Hexapod Walker by Khan. With simplistic design and no additional mass, it manages just to pass 5 FHS, almost 3 times the speed. Here is a fun fact. If you are more into speed than sophisticated six-legged creations, you should crouch and smoke them with the speed of 12.27 FHS. That's right, crouching makes you go faster than a walker. The next measurement I would like to bring your attention to is not a creation, but surely it is a big milestone. Walking speed in Scrap Mechanic. On a flat ground, our character speed is 16.6 FHS. At this point, we have our first real benchmark to compare with. But have in mind that going uphill or downhill makes the speed float a little bit. Back to the list. On 69th place, it's the only creation with vanilla tracks we were able to find. That's right, a track vehicle made without mods that works. We found this a long time ago, and every time we play around with it, we are just astonished. Those tracks bite seriously, and while driving, you won't even care for the top speed of 17.17 FHS. Speaking of vanilla parts, check out those rims and this bumblebee paint and look. Simplistic yet very pretty design and one of our favorite do-it-yourself wheels on the list. They have good grip and does amazing off-road, but doing amazing off-road comes with its price. The price of only 18.87 FHS. On 67th place we meet the Nail Spider. Getting up to speed of almost 22 FHS, it is something to fear. Combine that with 8 legs, a few jets, and it can climb everything and get you everywhere. Moving one place up, it is a very interesting measurement here. This is a simplistic 4-piston powered car by Gaming Knot. We all know that piston cars have massive torque, but are quite slow. We thought it's even slower, but we are surprised that it tops 22.6 FHS. We've been observing speed so much time here, but let's talk about what is speed. The definition says, the speed of an object is the rate at which it covers distance. The general formula for speed is distance divided by time. But how we measure this? Knowing in theory how to measure speed is one thing, but building it in scrap mechanic is another. To be able to achieve accurate and consistent results, we needed precise measurement device, and one of our chief engineers, Alex, built one especially for that, the Fun Hunter's stopwatch. Please check out our special video for it, as it incorporates few brilliantly made ideas. Thanks to it, we are able to measure the time needed to pass 4 different distances on our course. From 0 to 400 squares and from 0 to 1000 squares, and respectively top speed at the end of each of them. We rank the creations first by top speed, and if there are two or more with same value, we compare time needed from 0 to 1000 squares. Now, it is time to present to you one of the most important measurements for me that we've made. If your pinky hurts from hours and hours of holding the shift button on your keyboard, then you would like to know that the price for this is a running speed of 33.33 FHS. This makes running 2 times faster than walking, and as we can see, faster than quite a few creations. What if you wanna go 1 FHS faster than running, but bring party music and dance lights with you? Then the Party Tractor by Warpaint is for you. This creation is a blast to hang around with, and there is space for all of your friends, so you won't drink alone like alcoholic. So far from our list, you can see that walkers are not really fast and you can easily outrun them. But think again, one place below 60 we can find lucky creation with equally lucky name. Behind those sharp feet we can find ultra stable walker with a couple of hidden features. The speed booster surely comes in handy, but having the ability to extend its legs just won our hearts. This makes it the only creation in our list that is able to jump over our fences. To be fair, it is capable of speeds more than measured 41 FHS, but it had to retract the legs in order to get to our gates. Knowing the true potential and fun we had with this one, it surely deserves a better place in our list, but rules are rules. This part of the list is where we can fight a lot of military vehicles, and on 56th place sits one of the best, the M35 army truck created by a couple of guys who have done an awesome job. You can tell that so much time and care went to it by the details. From the hook at the back, the locking mechanism of the flatbed door, the cargo it is carrying, the bolts at the rims, And just wait until you open the hood and check out the 4-cylinder engine with intake and exhaust, and even a plus and minus battery terminals. You'll get the point, it's just jaw-dropping. And the great ideas does not stop here. They've done some great job underneath too. It feels powerful, and the lucky and strange suspension gives you good grip, and it's easy to control up to the top speed of 55.56 FHS. At 54th place we are very surprised to find out the Fun Hunter's Octo, one of our prototype builds meant to be a testbed for next generation of our system ESAM or Electronic Steering Angle Modifier. It was first used in our Gecko Truck, but this little cutie was meant to bring it one step further and to be able to turn on a dime. Not to be fast in a straight line, but the neat suspension helps it to achieve 66.67 FHS. And we are really proud of this! Continuing the military team, on 51st place we find the T-55A by OZA. This is a tank for crew of 3 with integrated so much realism and details that is hard to believe. For example, crew members have separate seats with different roles for each. The driver can turn the lights and has the ability to control the tank. And driving it feels really close to War Thunder or World of Tanks, which was quite surprising. The commander can operate the infrared lights, the radio, and give orders as expected. The party piece though is when you get in the gunner seat. Controlling the turret is smooth, aiming is fun, and between each shot that has no back, you have to reload. And those are accompanied by sound effects that are really cool. I just love to reload and hear the sound after it's done. This is such a great creation that you would not care for speed, but it is worth to mention that this is the first creation in our list that goes over 70 FHS. Small talks for big things. As you guys are scrap mechanics yourself, I'm sure you're already wondering how fast your creations are and how you would do in our list. We want to share this experience with you all, so you can have as much fun measuring your speed as we did. If you want to build your own measuring device, check out the great video about the Fun Hunter stopwatch and download it for free from the Steam Workshop. But if you wanna go straight to the action, or you're just lazy, don't waste your time, but download our FHS meter instead. Get your result in 7 easy steps. Subscribe in Steam Workshop. Build the FHS meter. We recommend welding it to the ground to avoid unnecessary lag. Activate it once with the yellow button. Reset with the red button. After getting your results, you are ready for the last step. Divide 100 by your time and you will receive the speed in FHS. And although we do not believe in fluttered in scrap mechanics, we know that some of you would love to test on-road creations, so we have prepared special second version especially for you. In Steam Workshop, it is marked with C for concrete. All 3 creations are tested, tuned, and best of all, free for you to download from Steam Workshop. They took us months to create, so please leave us a like, test them, and don't forget to share your best score in the comments below. Here is a classic car that is just a joy to look at. The Mercedes-Benz SSK has those sleek lines that brings the spirit of the original one out. As such small creation, it has a lot of details on it, even the sexy external exhaust pipes. The smart way the steering is done makes it quite enjoyable to ride, and the only downside is the low clearance, but this is to be expected from a race car after all. Despite that, it manages to achieve almost 77 FHS on our off-roadish course. On 43rd place, it is the first bike in our list. Very futuristic looking and engineered, it has two separate wheels on the front that have independent suspension piece for each. The feeling of driving it matches the sci-fi look that seems to be from 2087, but fortunately the speed is only 87 FHS. We would say that this would be the perfect bike for a Sunday ride. With the same speed and futuristic vision, one place up, it is the Tractor by NoNo GT. It is a big green monster that has great pulling power and has the ability to extend its rear wheelbase. We suppose that the reason for this is the hitch on the back that you can connect attachments and trailers from Steam Workshop. But in our case, the ability increased the stability and helped for achieving the top speed. And in this tractor, speed feels quite faster than it really is, which is great. We hope that so far you're enjoying our list. We love it! If you feel the same way, why not give us a thumb up? We appreciate it and it helps a lot. These videos takes a lot of time planning, making, shooting and post-producing. So why don't you check our other episodes and playlists while you are waiting for part 2 of our top 72 list of fastest creations in scrap mechanics. But wait, what about all the Fun Hunters fans out there? Check out our Patreon page where you can get insights like behind the scenes, future projects, unpublished materials or just support us. Thank you for joining and see you in part 2.